What can we do? What is the magic answer to deal with a meltdown?
Little tantrum. I mean, it's embarrassing.
I just do this.
In our house, we called it going boneless. That's when the girls, when they were toddlers, would arch their backs, screaming uncontrollably, inconsolable, in a public place, of course, and there was nothing you could do to satisfy them. What do you do to deal with a meltdown?
Well, first of all, you want to prevent them.
Yeah,
okay?
Right.
I know.
Can you? Can you actually prevent them?
You know, you can, but I always say to parents, number one, forget about other people watching you, okay? You gotta stop, drop, and do what you have to do. And you escalating back to the child is not helping anything. You have to think of yourself as a tuning fork. The calmer and clearer you can be, the better things will go.
She's 6 years old, but she sounds like she's 13. Because I didn't do her ponytail properly. Because she wanted a ponytail like Ariana Grande, and I didn't put it in the right place, and she came out crying and said, Ariana Grande's ponytail is here, not here.
What did you say?
I was at a loss of words. I had no idea what to say. But my husband said, well, she's right, you know.
Mom.
Which didn't help the situation.
First we're gonna do is fire the husband, okay? He's got to go. That is not helpful whatsoever. What you might have asked her to do in that moment is say, honey, if you need help, say that. Say, Mom, I need help changing the ponytail. We can control the ponytail. We can't control the things in the outside world. So she has to be trained to be able to send herself the calm down signal. And as a parent for a six-year-old, it's your job to help her get there. So this is where you're laying the groundwork for that. And that is life-saving.